Loose ends. Welcome back, YouTube, to another episode of My Speaking Podcast. It's your boy Dunk Sardadara. Why you got all the gang? Pickin' Beans gang. Santee, South Carolina Finest, man. Welcome back.
It's your boy Mike, better known as Boogie, aka Choke Yourself, aka Reese's Pieces. Before we get started, we may not always be right. We may not always be wrong.
But you always gonna get that modest opinion what you're speaking on.
And on that right there, we came in on the, some loose ends just now.
But what y'all know about that, man?
Yeah, we're gonna talk about some loose ends right quick because been a lot of beef, man, going on in the hip hop world.
Oh man.
Who
the beefing, man?
Listen. I'm gonna just say this right quick.
Go ahead, man. Say it, man.
And I don't know you, brother. But Quavo, hey man, I think what you need to do, man, is go ahead and go to church, take a collection.
Oh man.
Go around and get a collection plate, man, and go around and just ask God for forgiveness, man. I really do, because this is how I know hip hop is different from what the era I grew up in. I'm quite sure what Dad grew up in. When you let an R&B dude that's known as R&B, not saying that he can't rap, I'm not saying that, because Chris got. He's a multi. He can dance. He can act. He can sing. He can do. He can do it all. But for you, let that man come in there and murk you like that, man. Hey, but that man say, the one line that got me to say, man, I wish it was you instead of take. I said, man, come on, man. I said, boy, it just. You might as well go out there and dig a plot, man, and dig some dirt, man, and jump in there and just and do like the cartoon and throw it on top, man.
Oh man, what going on with Drake and Rick Ross, man? Drake and Future.
Hey man, listen.
Hey man, everybody getting at him, man.
They call him White Boy, man.
What's it, man? Hey man, you knew he got a song on his album, and Jay-Z spoke to this song. He said they were gonna come after him.
Who? Jay-Z said they were going.
He rapped about it.
Jay said they were gonna come after him.
Here's how they're gonna come after you. Matter of fact, when you get a chance. Matter of fact, go to your phone right here. I can tell you which song it is. It's the album where he was, you know, he had a little picture of him with the little afro, little baby afro. I can tell you which song it is right now.
Tell me what you want, Scorpio?
Nope, not that one.
Cause he got a bunch of them with a little face on
him. This one right here, nothing was the same, man.
What am I saying?
I'm gonna see if I can find the song, man. Hold on.
And Jay is rapping in there with him.
Yep. Well, we gonna come back to that.
But the thing is, though, it's just that when you had rappers back then going at it, you had like the Takeover, with Jay-Z winning it, Nas. But we all know the song that Nas came back with. I think one of the greatest comebacks. One of the illest diss songs all the time, Ether. And when he came back with Ether, man, when he came in with his book, Jay-Z, I was like, what? I was like, man. But my thing is, that's what, you know,
and if I'm not, what it was all about.
Now, if I'm not, yeah, it was, because you had Cannabis and went to LL, went back to Cannabis.
You had Jada Kiss going at each other.
You had, back in the day, LL and Kumo. I mean, LL had... Yeah, they probably had more beef with more people than anybody else.
Pretty much, yeah.
But my thing is, that's what we grew up on hip-hop, because when you had, like, people going at certain people. But my thing is, it's all, they had it. And I'm not saying it's not out of, because, like I told my partner this, it's kind of ironic they started this beef maybe a month or two after the comedians were beefing. Who knows behind closed door? Because you got to understand, Cole have been with song with Drake. Cole have been with song with Kendrick. Cole have been with song with few. All of them been together. That's what I'm saying. So my thing is, all of a sudden everybody beefing with each other. Do y'all probably think, just hypothetically, think about this. When you had Cat Williams went on Club Shay Shay. Monique went on Club Shay Shay. Cat Williams went on tour out of that. Sold out everywhere. And then Monique, he said, come on, go with me. Do you think they are just capitalizing on what the comedians were doing?
I wouldn't doubt it.
I mean, who would to say they were like, you know what, y'all? The comedians made all this. Look how they making money and all this stuff together. Let's get together. I'm just hypothetically now, because I just don't see how all of these rappers all of a sudden started going at each other. It don't make sense to me.
Yeah, man. It's good because you're getting people interested in the hip hop stuff now. You know what I'm saying? The beef. Everybody like the little negative stuff, a little negative energy. Not saying that And then we just gonna keep it on wax, you know what I'm saying? They ain't got Biggie, they ain't got to go like as far as the East Coast, West
Biggie
Coast.
And Pac stuff, exactly. Was, yeah, the West
Coast. Keep it on wax, you know what I'm saying? All these cats, multi-millionaires, they got plenty of money, so they ain't, you know what I'm saying? They ain't really got to go.
But I mean, do you really think this stuff, okay, like, the only one I really believe is true.
Which one?
The Quavo and Brown and Chris, mm-hmm. is because of a female.
True.
So, in a lot of times in the world, things happen because of, things happen. Men beef
wars
about,
have been fought over
females. So I'm saying females are always in the middle of it. Mm-hmm. Not saying that I don't know this lady from Adam. I don't know who she is, but mm-hmm. basically, they was one of them were messing with her. One became an ex. Mm-hmm. The other mess. So it is. If you listen to the song, which I'm quite sure, if you ain't heard it mm-hmm. or seen it, you must be sleeping up on the rock by mm-hmm. now. But
let me ask you a question, you two. And I posed this to my partner right here. Out of Rick Ross, Drake, Kendrick, J. Cole, even Kanye in on it now. Kanye.
He in it too?
Yeah, he in it too. He got a song he got a song with it too. Those right there, right? All are great, great artists in there, right? Out of those five, Kendrick, Drake, J. Cole,
Ross,
and Kanye. If you were gonna get a rapper, one of those rappers, just say, okay, I'm gonna just go and diss everybody. Who you think would come out on top? If you had to pick one.
And before he backed out of it, I would have said Cole. But now that he's retracting and went back and said, you know, he didn't mean it, and you know, a lot of people. I heard even Lee at work saying he lost respect for him because. Mm-hmm. And like I told people, you gotta understand. But you gotta understand him as a person. A lot of people don't even know he was married all these years.
Yeah, he's married.
He don't even have tattoos. Mm. Cole is built different from most of these rappers. He has his own path. I mean, I'm quite sure he might have liked Jay and this, that, and that when he came out with Jay Sean. Cole is his own person. So you can't get mad at him because.
You can too, because you gotta think about it. Cole is a hip hop head. So Cole know the essence of hip hop is.
Because I even see Jay. Because like. Jada can say he really want to talk to him and figure out why did you go back. Yeah,
because that's the essence of hip hop.
And I'm quite sure the reason Jada can probably want to know because like all the rest of us, we know pound for pound. If you want to sit there and write lyrics, this kid, he's a kid.
He's one of the ones.
So, but maybe if something had to happen to him, and we don't know. But my thing is, it's okay for him. And I'm cool with it. Everybody is knocking him down. I'm cool with him saying, you know what, hey, man, I shouldn't have did it. At the time when you said it to me, I had to come back. Because they say he wrote this in 7 minutes. That's why he called it seven. Mm-hmm. So he wrote it, but I'm not mad at that. I'm not so much
mad
at that.
He wrote it, but he really didn't want to do it because, you know what I'm saying, he was just like, you know how you do something, you retaliate, like, you know what I'm saying, like a hit dog a bark, you know what I'm saying, you hit him, then, you know what I'm saying, okay, I got to do something back because you hit me. But maybe he didn't really mean it, you know what I'm saying, really meant it like that.
Well, but you got to think about it now. You said that right 7 minutes of you right.
But you got to think about, too, how big of a man it is to take, you know what I'm saying, you're going on a big stage in front of everybody.
He went on Dreamville, and when he went up there in Raleigh, he tried to apologize. Like I say, you know, I'm not mad at him.
Man to do that, right?
And I'm not mad at him, like I say, but I think Cole is one of those rappers that's, he's different from anybody. He's different in that way. Well, like, you know, Drake going at Ross, you know, because Ross was saying, Drake was like, no. Ross was saying, hey, if Birdman was your man, why don't you go down there? Because he's supposed to have been on a bankrupt, something. So he's like, he's like, why you ain't help your man out if you got this kind of money?
Hey, man.
And the thing is, to me, it's like, if you're talking about a beef and a particular, something happened, if y'all was somewhere and something particular happened, okay, you're beefing about that. But when you start talking about money, and you start talking about how much,
cats is beefing, they're beefing on a different level, bro. It's not like the beef like you in the streets, you know what I'm saying? You and your homeboy, you see somebody.
But that was so Jay-Z and Nas beef was, it was personal. That's personal. That was a real beef.
This beef right here, these cats talking about Rick Ross and, hey man, who gonna get a $35 million house, tear it down, and upgrade it to $50 million? They big money beef.
But you still beefing about money. To me, and that's the thing that I guess that I don't. But if you got, like I say, when Jay and Nas went at it, we knew it was something personal.
See, they can't make it personal because that's why the beef is going towards. Okay, what your money looking like?
They all got
got money.
But who got more?
So it's about ego.
Between Ross
and Drake.
Ross and Drake.
Yeah, so yeah. Basically, theirs is about money.
Yeah. I mean, it's about respect too, but they can't really beef like that because they work together so much. Think about it, man. Think about the songs that they done made together, man. Rick Ross.
They don't know what I'm saying. So y'all beefing.
They can't take it,
but they beefing about money.
They beefing.
Who got more money?
They beefing about money because they don't want to make it personal because they know they.
But think about that though. Y'all multi-millionaires.
It's like lifestyle of the rich and famous. Okay, man. I got the 89 Porsche. Oh no, I got the 99. You know what I'm saying?
But see, personally, that don't attract me. I don't want to listen because that's like listening to Floyd Mayweather.
True.
That's why I have a bias. Anytime, this is me. You got all this money. I'm happy you made your money. But you ain't got to flaunt your money.
True.
It's a different flaunt. Mayweather got all. Floyd Mayweather sitting there show his car collection. Mm-hmm. He'll pull money. I don't want to see that. I don't care. Because I'm like, I'm happy for you. Mm-hmm. Go out there and help some other people figure out how to make the money you made. Mm-hmm. If it ain't in boxing, it's some other way. Networking, help somebody else out. So you telling me Rick Ross done been with the chicken spot and Drake was on Nickelodeon and all this stuff. And now all of a sudden y'all came out. Because Rick Ross, when he first started, he was a security guard. So
Rick Ross was a ghostwriter for a lot of people too.
But that's after he became a security. He was a security guard when he first came out. But I'm saying. So my thing is, as a black man, I'm happy y'all. But my thing is, if you're gonna make a beef about something, make it about something that's
the only way they can beef. They can't make it because they're not in the streets.
Well, Chris Brown ain't beefing like that. That's personal.
That's personal. Not beefing because it's not about no girl.
But I'm saying.
You see what I'm saying?
But you can see what I'm saying. Rick Ross. I mean Drake. I mean. Pretty much Chris Brown and Quavo's is better.
Okay, yeah.
Because simple fact, they going at it. They going at each other. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. When Quavo came out first, it was like, you know, and everybody was saying that he is one of the mastermind, but he's not the spirit. They say the one who passed.
Takeoff.
They say he was the one.
Offset. Takeoff is the one that passed.
They said that's the one who really could rap.
Rest in peace to Takeoff.
Yeah, rest in peace. But Quavo, they said it's pretty much like, but when you got, like I said, when you got
a hook, you call just boy. Like he like
well, he got a hook.
He like what's my man name for the that was with Dr. Dre. I mean Death Row.
When
you need a hook,
you talking about the guy who sing
Nate Dogg
who passed. Yeah,
you need a hook for a song, hey, call Nate.
Nate was on so many. But like I say, it just to me is like, if you're gonna, to me personally, if you're gonna have a beef, make it about even, I'm not saying have a beef. Mm-hmm. I'm saying, if you gotta have a beef, make it about something that, okay, you know what? This cat did something to me. I don't like it. And he know about it. I'm gonna go in the studio. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna give you something. Mm-hmm. And then, but let me ask you this. Out of the ones you said, not the ones you just named, what's a person out there that you don't want to have a beef with? Because if you do, it's gonna be hell to pay. What's a rapper out there or a couple rappers out there that you would not want to beef with? Because if you do, you're gonna have some problems. Basically, that's what I'm saying. I know two come off of mine.
I mean, you can think Jada because it was the versus battle with Cameron.
Listen, hey, man, that's still epic to this day.
And
Eminem for me.
Eminem, yeah.
Eminem, listen.
You don't cross that.
See, that's what I'm saying? Certain ones, you like.
You don't want to cross that street, man.
Like, you know, Future, okay. He's upset about something. And like I say, even with Kendrick, I don't see these guys.
And I found the song too. Hey, do me a favor, go ahead and hit the record. I found the song too. And I'm going to show you how Jay-Z kind of predicted it a little bit on this right here. This is a song right here. YouTube. Which y'all want to go to it now, you know, it's called Light Up. It's on Drake's Thank Me Later album, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, he kind of talking about it a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna just go to his little part, you know, real quick, like
Jay-Z part.
Yeah, Jay-Z part, yeah.
I got these new rappers nervous prom night. I grow tired of these grown man like. They must be talking to themselves, hold hands free.
Yeah,
and I'm just filling up this daily planner. Getting busy cause I'm a star, no spangle. This life, let's celebrate with a toast. And get lost in the
fucking tonight and make it all light up.
Hey Google, tell home girl to open that ace.
Wait until the sun goes down. We gon' make, even when the sun goes down, I'ma make it go.
Ow, turning heads like owls. I'm the man of the owl. Triple entendre, don't even ask me how. Con Edison flowing, connected to a high power. Bright lights to make your whole city light up. A trillion watt light bulb when I'm in the nightclub. I just landed in that G450. Caught the Mayweather fight cause the satellite was crispy. Y'all can miss me with the money talk. The smart money's on hold for what the dummies talk. I don't do too much blogging. I just run the town, I don't do too much jogging. I ain't got a scar yet. You can rattle me and my dogs as far-fetched. Drake, here's how they gon' come at you. With silly rap fans trying to distract you. In disguise, in the form of a favor. The bar seen me, watch for the traitors.
So he pretty much did, hey, this how they gonna come after you.
Well, I mean, like I say, I mean, and my thing is, I know Ricky calling them white boy, mm-hmm. and they going back and forth, mm-hmm. that and other, but I'm like, theirs is not, it's not catching my eye.
It's not catching
my ear. It's not catching my ear to mm-hmm. sit there, but I listen to it because mm-hmm. it's entertainment, mm-hmm. but like when I heard Chris Brown,
you like,
it put me right in the mind, if you close your eyes, you like, you back in the day when Nas and Jay-Z were beefing.
Who you were, who that rap that Chris Brown did for Quavo, where would you put that as far as when you hear it?
What
it make you think of, you know, of this song? What this song can make you think of back in the day when you heard it? It's like, man, that put me in the mind of such and such. Like, would it be a Nas? Would it be Cannabis?
No.
Would it be a...
It definitely was... Cannabis hit hard.
Yeah.
He hit hard against L.
Second round knockout.
I don't care what nobody said.
Second round knockout. Boy.
People keep saying when Jack the Ripper came back mm-hmm. out that I still say to this day Cannabis ate him. That's just my opinion.
Man, that second round knockout was no joke, man.
But to me, the best diss song all time was Ether. It's nothing because Ether is, you know, because don't get me wrong, the takeover, even when Jay-Z went to MTV and mm-hmm. made MTV Live, mm-hmm. he had everybody. You know, all the crowd singing, mm-hmm. you know, you're lame mm-hmm. and all that. But when you heard Ether, the first line come out, book Jay-Z, mm-hmm. you pop, 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 pop.
Ben trying to steal my swag, man.
Even to this day, when you hear that, you be like, man. Boy, I mean, it is.
Woo. It is what it is, man.
But like I said.
Shout out to all both of them. Shout out to Jay-Z. Shout out to Nas, you know.
But it just, it's one of those things where that. I'm glad they're trying to bring hip hop back to where it's supposed to be, but listen to this right here.
Fuck Jay-Z.
What's up, niggas?
When you hear that right there, man, you know that man, he was coming for blood.
Blood.
And like I say, that's what I'm looking for, and that's what Chris Brown pretty much did to Quavo. Yeah, when he came back, and I'm like, yo. And even he said at the end, he said, man, you let an R&B dude kill you. I'm like, yo.
Man. It was like
yeah, it was like that fight of the night. It was like Hayne against Ryan Garcia. Hey, that's man. Exactly what it was.
Yeah, man, it was like
Quavo was Devin Haney, and Chris Brown was Ryan Garcia. You do all this talking,
mm-hmm.
and then when Ryan Garcia knocked him out with that left, kept him with that left.
I'm putting his hands on you,
man. And it was pretty much it. So, like I say, man, y'all let us know what y'all think about the state of hip hop. You know, everybody dissing everybody. You think it's real content?
Is it good for hip hop?
Or you think it's real content? Or you think they're doing it just to make money behind closed doors? Or they call each other? What do you all think? So let us know what y'all think, man. Hit that like, subscribe, and comment. Let us know what y'all think. Get back with us again, man. I'll let you later. Peace out.
Peace out, man.